My name is Saika, and I'm here to talk to you today about some of the aspects of visual impairment and the different things, the challenges that people can face as a visually impaired person. I'm going to start by making a differentiation between those people who are actually born blind and those people who become blind later in life with something like cataracts. Those of us who are actually born blind, for us, to be honest with you, blindness isn't a big deal for the simple reason that we've never had sight. So for us, it's quite normal to be born blind. So the brother who kindly says that we suffer with it, I think that's giving us too much credibility, because to be honest with you, for me, it's daily life. But those of us who are actually lose our sight later in life, it's for them that I think the real challenges start. It's for them that we have to think about, you know, what it must be like to lose your sight. The only thing I can liken it to is being able to losing my hearing. I mean, for me, and I'm saying this is a blind person, I can't imagine what it must be like to lose my hearing. So all I can actually do is just guess that this must what it like must to lose sight. In first world countries, we have lots and lots of services for those of us who are visually impaired. People are taught Braille at the age of around 5 years old, and they are also, you are allowed to go to school, you have every single facility at your fingertips. But those people who are in developing countries, who are actually either born blind or lose their sight later in life, frankly, life's miserable for them. They have, as the brother said earlier, you have to rely on other people to get you from A to B. Here, within the UK, that's not a problem. I wander around, my cousin Bilal wanders around with a white cane or with a guide dog. But within places like Pakistan, Palestine, and Gaza, these aren't an option, these in places like this. I'm going to talk to you one other thing about attitudes towards blindness. Now, Muslims, as with many other communities, blindness is something that's often misunderstood. And in some respects, it's actually slightly feared because of the fact that people know very little about it. So if I ask you to think about one thing from this particular presentation, is to take away the idea that if you see somebody with a disability, and it doesn't matter who this particular person is, just to go up to them and just to give them salam, if nothing else.